Dear Commissioner, dear colleagues, it's a pity that the Council isn't here because I think the Council should be part of this debate here today. And before I'm going to go into the oral question and the resolution, I would first like to remind again what started this or what triggered this whole process, and that was the murder of Daphne Caruana Galizia, Jan Kuciak and his fiancée Martina Kuznirova. And I think we should always recall their names and make sure that they're not forgotten. We are discussing today the oral question and the draft resolution that we will vote on later this year, and it has been drafted together with all the main political groups by the Rule of Law Monitoring Committee, and it is the result of almost a year, 10 months of hearings, on-site visits, meetings, correspondence, video conferences with governments, with the police, public prosecutor, journalists, NGOs, experts, farmers, and many, many more. And I think that if we look at the text of the resolution as it is today, it focuses on Malta and Slovakia, but not exclusively. It is, on the one hand, yes, it is highlighting concerns and criticisms and shortcomings. But I'm happy to say that it is also welcoming and noting some very positive developments. And I think the lesson that we can draw from this is that Europe works. It is clear that the intervention of the European Union helps the member states coming back on track where they risk running off the tracks when it comes to the rule of law and fundamental rights. The resolution makes a couple of recommendations which are also summarized in the questions to the Commission. We have some specific recommendations to Malta and Slovakia. One concerns is actually a recommendation to the European Commission, inviting the European Commission to start a rule of law dialogue with Malta. We think that that would be justified. At the same time, I also intend to put forward amendments recognizing the fact that the Maltese government has now announced that they will implement the recommendations of the Venice Commission. But nevertheless, I think a dialogue would be appropriate. We would also recommend that the brain behind the murder of Daphne Caruana Galizia is caught. Not just the people who committed the murder, but also the brain behind it. And we also have a general call to end the scheme of golden visas and golden passports, not just in Malta, but in all the member states. With regard to Slovakia, we note that the probable brain behind the murder has not only been caught, but also charged with, amongst other things, the murder of Jan and Martina. And I'm happy to say that further inquiries into corruption and connections with organized crime are being conducted. Nevertheless, some concerns remain concerning the so-called system of revolving doors. We see some of the people who stepped down actually coming back in other jobs. And we would also urge the Slovak government to end the deadlock in the nominations to the Constitutional Court and to refrain from adopting the new media law. And finally, there are some general recommendations to all of us. First of all, it has become clear to me in the course of the work of the Rule of Law Monitoring Group that we need to strengthen Europol, because now Europol can basically only do its job when it's invited by the member states. And then people will say, yeah, but that's subsidiarity. But we also see that when public authorities themselves are engaging in wrongdoing, then we should have the means as European Union to come in. Why? Because we are a system altogether. If one of the member states undermines the rule of law, if one of the member states doesn't apply our common rules and standards, then basically the whole European system is broken. So I think we have every reason to strengthen that system and strengthen Europol. I would also call on the Commission to reinstate its annual corruption report, because we don't feel that the current formula in the European semester is strong enough. And finally, we would urge the Commission, in particular Mr. Timmermans, who's not here today, to finally respond to the call, the repeated calls of the European Parliament for a comprehensive mechanism, the so-called DRF Pact, the Democracy, Rule of Law, Fundamental Rights Pact. And I see that both Spitzenkandidaten, Mr. Weber and Mr. Timmermans, neither of them is really committed to a comprehensive, non-political, objective, mechanism, and the Member States only want a peer review mechanism. I
Thank
would
you,
really
colleague.
Hope for the Commission.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. I think it was absolutely clear.